Hey everybody, welcome back. So in this video we're going to be doing some geometry layout. And the first thing that we're going to need to do is create a new project. And to do so, we are on the Unreal Project browser here and the New Project tab. We're going to use a template for this video series. So go ahead and make sure that the Blueprint First Person template is selected. This will give us a character that can run around and jump and shoot and do all kinds of cool stuff for us. So make sure that that is selected. Also make sure that starter content is enabled, which it should be by default. If it is not, you can click it and then choose with starter content. This will allow us to add some props and things to our level once we get near the end of the video series, just to make our level look a little prettier. With that, choose a save location for your project and go ahead and give it a name and then hit create project. I already have a project, so I'm just going to pop that up so you don't have to watch my project loading. And while yours is loading, let's talk about what we see here. When your project opens, you will be presented with the first person template map. And if I were to play in the editor now, let's go ahead and hit play. You'll see I have a character that can run around and shoot and jump just like we wanted. So that's perfect. There's one thing that we wanted to make a change to really quickly. Because we're trying to create a realistic environment, we're going to go ahead and hide this blue man here. If you could see the blue hand and blue gun there, we're going to hide that because it kind of kills our immersion. So it's quick and easy. So let's go ahead and do that. So with your project open, go to the first person blueprint folder and the blueprints folder inside of it and double click the first person character blueprint. It'll take a second to load up, and when it does, you'll be presented with some script for the character movement and shooting. We're not going to worry about any of that. We're just going to go over to the viewport tab here, and if I zoom out a little bit, you can see we have our player camera, the collision, and the mesh. And up in the components window in the upper left, we're going to select the mesh 1P. That is our character's arms and everything there. And then in the upper right in the details panel, we're going to go ahead and search for owner. That'll give us two options, only owner C, which is kind of self-explanatory, and owner no C, which is unchecked, but we're going to check this so that we do not see this mesh when we play. So we're going to hit compile and save, and then close the blueprint. And just a quick test to make sure that works. Yes, it does. So we do not see the blue character anymore, but we can still shoot and everything. So we are good for our player character. So hit escape to pop out there. And we could start building our level now. We could start building from this existing map here, but we're going to create a brand new level for us to work with. So go up to File up here and select New Level. Now we're presented with two options here. We're presented with an empty level, which is completely blank. We have the default map, which our default level, which gives us a skybox and some sun and some other things. So go ahead and select the default, and don't worry about saving content for this map. And there we go. Here's our new level. It has some clouds in it and a sun and some fog, and we are good. So let's go ahead and select the player start. We're going to kill this. Hit delete. We don't need that for now. And the floor, we're going to delete that as well because we're going to add our own. So with that, let's go to the modes panel here and make sure that we are in placement mode by clicking this first tab here, which is the default option. And then the BSP tab or tab here, go ahead and select that and drag a box brush into your level. This is going to be our floor. So let's make some adjustments to this in the details panel over here. Let's change the X, Y, and Z values for this. For the X, let's set this to 500. For the Y, let's set that to 500. And for the Z, let's set that to 20, because we don't need a very thick floor. We just need a floor. And there we go. There's our first floor piece. One thing before we continue, if you can kind of pick this up on the video, I don't know how apparent it is on the video, but surrounding our area here, our level, is this grid. This just makes level construction a little bit easier. It helps things make sure that they're aligned by snapping things to this grid. And as I move this piece here, you can kind of see that it snaps in increments here. We're actually going to change that value, and you can do so in the upper right up here. We're currently set to 10. We're actually going to change that to 50. And now we can see our grid a little bit better. And I'm going to reselect our floor piece here just really quickly. And I need to make sure that this piece is actually snapped to our grid. So I'm going to hold Control and press End. And you see it kind of jumped a little bit. That made sure that it was snapped to our grid. So if I hit Control Z, currently it isn't, but Control and End together. There we go. Now it is snapped to our grid. So we're ready to continue now. We have our first piece here. Go ahead and hold Alt and grab this green arrow here and just drag it to the right. That's going to create a copy for us. And now we have two pieces. So let's hold Control and select the other piece so that we have both and do that same procedure. Just hold Alt, drag this red arrow to the left here so that we have four pieces. So this is a good foundation for our floor here. We have four pieces. We could have just dragged in one box brush and made it this size, but doing it this way, this modular way, allows us a better way of applying materials later, because we can place one material on this, one material on this, or do this side as one material. If we did one big box brush, then we would have had one material, but we want some variety. So this is a good start. So let's go ahead and start adding some walls. Select a floor piece here and hold Alt and drag it up into the air. And we could press E here and we could rotate it 90 degrees like so. That looks like a wall to me. We're going to do it a little bit different way here. So I'm going to hold Control and Z to go back and W to switch back to the Move tool here. We're just going to punch in the values for these so that we get the exact measurements we want for our wall. So I'm going to make some changes in the brush settings here. I'm going to set X to 500, leave that as it is. For our thickness of our wall, the Y here, I'm going to change that to 20. And for the Z, our height, I'm going to make that 300. So there is our wall piece there. And let's grab this green arrow here and drag it to the left so that it is flush with our floor and our, are lined up on the side there. No, we're going to have to make some changes to our grid snapping value. So let's click that again and bump that to 10. And let's try and see if it lines up now. That looks good. It is up in the air a little bit here, but it looks like it's aligned with the floor. Another keyboard shortcut here. With my piece selected, if I press End by itself, if you recall, Control N snaps it to the grid. But if I press End by itself, that will snap it to the floor. So if I have a piece way up in the air like this, I could just press End, boom, snaps it right down to the floor piece below it, which is a handy, quick handy tool. So it doesn't look like it's flush with the edge here, so I'm gonna move it over a little bit, and there we go. Okay, just like we did before, let's hold Alt, grab this red arrow, and drag it to the left so that we have the wall there. And again, like we did with the floor, I'm going to hold Control so that I have both pieces selected. I'm going to hold Alt and drag that across. And there is our outer wall pieces. Okay, one thing that we need to do now, let's actually, if you see this little sun icon here, go ahead and select that. You can see that this white arrow here indicates the direction in which our sun is pointing. We want to move that to the other side there. And there's a neat little trick you can do. If you hold Shift while moving an object, you can see that it's moving the camera and the object at the same time, which is kind of handy. We could have moved the object and then move the camera, and then move the object with the camera, or we could zoom way out. This is equally as viable of an option. But if there's situations where you want to be in tight and you want to move the camera and an object at the same time, just hold Shift while you are moving, and that will allow you to do so. So I'm just going to move this over. It doesn't have to be anywhere in particular, just so that it's pointing in this general direction. That's good. So we're going to leave this side actually open, and we're going to add a walls on this side. So let's select a floor piece here, and I'm going to hold Alt, drag it up into the air, and punch in some values for this. Let's set the X to 20, and the Y to 480, and the Z for our height to 300 as well. So there's our wall piece. Let's grab the red arrow and drag it to the edge here. That looks good. I'm just going to pop it up and into the air and press End. There we go. So that is on the floor. It looks like it's clipping into that wall a little bit. So grab the green arrow and just bump it over. Yep. There we go. And let's hold Alt, drag the green arrow, and move it over. So then we have another one. There we go. So we have three walls and our side that's going to be open. With this piece still selected, go ahead and select the outer walls by holding Control and clicking on each of the outer walls here. We're actually going to raise the roof a little bit here. So hold Alt and click this blue arrow and drag it up into the air. Doesn't matter how high, and press end. That will snap it down to the pieces below it, which is perfect. And we left this area open for a reason. We're actually going to extend this piece out so that it is flush with this edge here. So we get a little bit of an overhang in here. So to do that, I'm gonna press escape to deselect everything. And we're gonna go to the modes panel over here. We're gonna click this icon here for geometry editing mode. This will allow me to edit these brushes here. So with this mode enabled, I'm gonna click this brush, and then I'm gonna click this face so that it is highlighted. Now I'm gonna grab this green arrow and just drag it over as if I were moving it so that it looks like it is flush, and that looks pretty good. And I'll press escape a few times to deselect it, and there we go. Now we have a little bit of an overhang there. Let's go back to placement mode. Let's click this here so that we are in placement mode, and let's grab, hold control and grab this floor piece, and this floor piece. We are going to drag these up and make a roof. We don't need this piece because this is already there for our roof. So with those selected, I'm gonna hold Alt and drag these pieces up. And it looks like it is flush with the edge there, which it is, that looks good. There's a little bit of a lip here, which is probably fine. I could leave it like this, but I'm gonna be super picky and fix that. So I'm just gonna go to geometry editing, gonna click this brush, then click this face, and drag that up like so, there. Just had to fix it, it was bothering me. So there we go, there is our blocked out level. We are probably gonna stop here, but I did wanna illustrate one thing before we close up this video. Let's go back to placement mode really quickly before I forget. We're actually gonna build our level and our lighting because I wanted to illustrate something really quickly. So go ahead and click build up here for the main toolbar. This will take just a second while the lighting builds. And once our lighting is built, you can see that we are now getting shadow coming in from the light here, and our area inside here is pretty dark. So if I were to fly in here, actually though, there's one thing that occurs. It may take a second on the video to kind of illustrate this. You can see how it gets a little bit brighter when we are in here. And if I zoom out, now it looks like it's really dark, but again, if I zoom in here, it kind of brightens up. That's because some eye adaptation is occurring. And while this is cool for gameplay purposes, you know, going from indoor to outdoor areas and having your eyes adjust as it would in real life, which is kind of cool, may not be as useful while you are building your levels and you're trying to, you know, do some lighting, might kind of get in the way of your construction. So it's just a workflow thing, depending on how you want to do it. You can turn this off, actually, if you go to the lit option up here and you go down to the exposure, go ahead and click fixed at log zero. That will turn that off. So if I go into this dark area, it will stay dark. And I come from light and go into dark, it will stay dark now, which is one method of working. Okay, the final thing that I wanted to mention for this video is just, again, another workflow thing. You can don't have to follow along with this, but I thought I would mention it. Inside my level here, if I hold L and I left click somewhere in here, there we go. I may have to do it a couple times. I'm not sure exactly why that is, but if you hold L and left click, you will get a light. It will create a light for you. So you can have a temporary work light if you were back in here and you wanted to do some stuff, but it was too dark to see what was going on. You can have a temporary work light. You could also, if you go to this little drop down up here, lock the viewport to an actor, and our point light is selected, so we could lock it to our point light. Now as I fly around, we have this little light attached to us, which is kind of like a helmet with a light attached to us, which is kind of cool because then we can come in here and do some work and then fly back out. It's kind of like the eye adaptation thing, but we can, because this is a light that is placed on our level, we can change the settings. We can brighten it up or make it, you know, dark, whatever we want. Just another way of working. So I thought I would mention that. So with that, let's actually break here. In the next video, we're gonna create the windows and doors. So let's go ahead and wrap this video up, and we will see you in the next video.